many things can help in making a leader successful. First, we have to define what success is. The way I define leadership is about mobilizing people and organizations so that they can survive and grow. How do they do that? By facing their realities, by dealing with their problems, finding solutions to them. If they're stuck, they get out of that situation and they move forward, or by capturing or creating opportunities for progress. So that's what success means when you're exercising leadership, is the group or people that you're trying to mobilize and lead will be able to create a better reality. Now, what makes that person successful? What makes the person successful is that your heart has to be in the right place, because you have to understand that this is going to be a tough and challenging and maybe sometimes also, you know, painful journey, because it's going to be full of setbacks and it will require sacrifices. So your heart has to be in the right place. Number two, your mind has also to be in the right place. So you have to know how to think properly. And that's an entire art and science by itself, how to think properly. So that when you make decisions, when you interpret, when you look at data, when you observe them, when you make your interpretation, diagnosis, you know, think of options, generate options, and then make judgments on which option to take, that needs clear thinking. You need to know how to think. So that's the second one. Another one is you have to know how to mobilize people. And that's a tough one, because you've heard this and you know it from yourself. I mean, just look around you and people around you. Human beings are significantly complex beings, creatures. We're a human being, we're a very difficult and complex species. There are good sides to this and there are difficult sides to this. But in general, it's really hard to mobilize people, because you need to understand human nature. And this is basic in leadership. How can you mobilize people if you don't understand human nature? And that involves knowing who they are, knowing their identity, knowing their values, knowing their thinking patterns, knowing their scars and wounds, knowing their history, heritage, you know, habits, what matters to them, what doesn't matter to them, dreams, fears, hopes, you name it. Their background, where they're coming from, where they're heading, what do they want, what are their desires, what are their nightmares, what are their phobias, what are their prejudices. You have to know all of this. How they're influenced, who is influencing them. You have to understand the whole thing. Basically, you have to be a master in understanding human nature. There's another one. You have to understand also yourself, because you're also part of the game. So how can you mobilize people if you don't understand your human nature as a human being? Your resilience, your threshold, where what makes you cry, what makes you laugh, what gets you going, what drains your energy, what drains your heart, what gets you excited, where is your tolerance limit physically, intellectually, emotionally? You have to understand yourself at all these levels. Once you've done that and you have clarity on your purpose, you have clarity on what you want to achieve, you have clarity at least on a sense of direction, on the reality that you want, that you aspire to create, you and the people around you and the organization around you, then you get yourself ready and you start your journey. And then the story begins. And it's going to be an epic story. Of course, it depends on the context. But usually, it's that exciting. Because as I said, you're dealing with people and you're dealing with yourself. So it's going to be a roller coaster, emotional, at an emotional level, at the intellectual level, at the social level, and maybe even at the physical level, financial level, I mean, you name it, professional level, organization level, you name it. But that's the nature of reality. So if you get all these elements, if you pay attention to them and start working with, you know, on enhancing them, getting ready for them, then the possibility of success in your strategies, as you design these strategies for progress or solving problems, and the implementation of these strategies in a very dynamic and changing environment will be higher. It is the most exciting thing ever to lead people, but it also is the most stressful thing. But I can't think of anything that is more rewarding and fulfilling, you know, to feel that you are part, at least you are a main driver in creating better realities for people around you, where finally they look at you and they say thank you, or they say without you we couldn't have done it. And then you tell them, no, we did it together. And the euphoria and the celebration and the satisfaction, the internal one that comes with that, is unimaginable, because it gives you meaning, man. It gives you meaning at your core level, because you've done something good, you've made life better, and you feel the appreciation. Now, it's all not always, of course, a happy ending, but at least you are involved in something worthwhile and honorable. And that's what leadership is all about.